for the YouTube. Off to Seastars. First to Swaffham to meet my mate Steve, and we're going to ride there together. So, but it's just started raining now. Hopefully, it's just spitting. That will go. Yeah, he's got a light that's come up on his dashboard and his bike, so he's gonna get it checked out. On his BMW S1000RR. It's good that I've got a gear and how many miles, or your rev counter, so your RPM and your gear indicator. So I only thought it told you when you were in sixth gear, but actually now you've got a little mode that tells you what gear in, which I didn't realise it had. So I had a little play around the other day, so I know what RPMs I'm doing and what gear I'm in, so it's quite good really. I think every bike should at least have something telling you what gear you're in. Like, even if it's like sixth gear, just to let you know when you're in the top gear, because when I'm on a Triumph, I have nothing telling me at all what gear I'm in. So when I'm riding the bike, I'm in sixth gear, but don't realise it. I'm trying to shift to go for another gear because I feel like I could change another gear. So, to have something that just comes up and says, yeah, you're in your last gear, would be ideal really. My phone's been going off mental, keeps pinging, so someone's been texting me. I hope that ain't Steve telling me he's not coming. Oh wow, I'll pull over in a minute. if it gets a bit wet, I'll just clean the bike tomorrow. I've been looking in the garage at my Triumph. When I come back from the gym the other day, it was raining, caught me out. That's all got mud all over it, and I mean, to some people, it's probably not, you know, nothing to worry about, but for me, I just see one little speck and it does my nothing. I can't leave it in there like that. I've got to have it looking clean, like showroom clean, you know? Sometimes when I clean them, I don't want to take them out again because I'm worried about, obviously, it's not just the mud and stuff, it's all those dead flies on your front and all that, and just cater your bike. So every time I go to take a bike out, all I keep thinking about is the cleaning part again. I think, oh, I've got to clean this again. Because I can't relax until it's clean. Pull up here somewhere, I think. This is overgrown. There was a bit up here on this corner coming up, I think. Yeah, on this corner here. I think I can. Yeah, there's a little. It's not a brilliant road, but I need to check my phone, and I've just realised my helmet's loose. Sort this out. That's better. Can't believe that. I don't know how bad this is. The wind started blowing a bit and I felt my helmet feels a bit loose and I forgot to do the strap. Wow, traffic's bad. Shall we say? Typical, isn't it? About an hour ago, sun was out, it was getting really warm. I was thinking about having less layers on, or a thinner coat, and just as I go to leave, it starts to spit, overcast, a little bit colder. Typical. Oh well. long as you don't have a massive downpour. I should have said that, Ray, should I? Breaking the clouds, so God, I don't know what it's gonna be like. It's a shame it's not a nice sunny day, because it's not only is it nice to ride in the nice weather, it's also nice to watch as well. When they watch the videos, it looks a bit gloomy out. It's, you know, just having that bit of sunlight on the screen makes all the difference, I think. Not just to your riding, but like I said, just to the viewing the video as well. Just makes the scenery look nicer as well. Get a bike out for a longer ride. Just going to the gym every day, it's only been like, what, I don't know, a couple of miles, if that, 2 miles. So to do this is a nice little treat, getting it out. Nice run. If I hadn't have planned anything, I probably wouldn't have gone out, but as I already planned to meet him to go to Seastars to have his bike looked at, you know, he could have probably gone earlier, but because I arranged to meet him, I felt a bit like bad to let him down, turn around to the last minute and say, nah, I'm not going now. So I decided to come. I mean, if it was obviously pouring it down like really bad, I wouldn't have bothered going, but it's only spitting. Hello? You what? Is it? Oh, I mean, as I was leaving Watton, it started to spit, and then I'm going towards Swaffham, and it's just it was just spitting, but it's sort of stopped now. So I'm hoping I've missed it, you know. Yeah, I'll be careful. Yeah, no worries. Yeah, because I had ready prepped, ready to go out, so I didn't want to just change it last minute. I mean, I would have probably have turned around and not bothered going, but because I've arranged the meeting and he's held on and waited for me, I felt a bit guilty to turn around and say, oh, I'm not going now, mate. Yeah. Oh, of course I will. Yeah, I'm not silly. Yeah, I will. All right. Okay. Alright, I can't hear you now. Love you, bye. Now we're in Swaffham. Oh, it's the north, I can see. Swaffham. At least my boots are waterproof anyway. It's not raining that way.
It's not supposed to be raining.
Alright. Alright, mate.
It's supposed to stop by 1 o'clock.
Okay, we're going back that way though, or we're going, what way are we going to go? I don't know this way very well.
Yeah, well, we go down the line and back out that way.
Okay, I'll follow you. So, have I got to turn around or are we going to go that way?
If you want, I'll go through that way.
Alright. Are we going to go traffic lights and turn left?
Straight over.
Oh, straight over. Alright, mate. Stephen. Well, typical bloody rain. Typical English weather. jeans are getting wet. This way very well, so I'm following Steve. I don't know the corners or junctions, so I'm not going to go silly. What's he doing? Oh, he's lost. He's like me then, I can understand it. Seastars. Right, it's just starting to spit again. My trousers have got absolutely soaked, but on the dual carriageway, it's soon dried up off with a bit of wind. It's not really that cold, but I think because of the wind, there's a little bit of wind in the air. My fingertips are getting a bit cold. this is it. This is the Seastars. Yes. So it's just up here on your right. My hands are cold. Wow.
Mine are a little bit cold, they're cold for ice cream.
Sorry?
Yeah, mine's all good.
Jesus, pretty cold.
I could stop the light by that.
Thank you. When's the new Ducati coming out? Because obviously they're stopped in the Panic Island, haven't they? And
there's one final edition that's being built at the moment, which is the 1299R final edition. And then we expect to see the launch of the new V4 around the Dakar time. And that'll be on the same plan.
And is Harley buying out Ducati?
They are in the pipeline to be the ones if anyone's going to buy, but that hasn't been.
Nothing's confirmed. I see it all over the place, and my friend Dean, he's got the anniversary Aero one, 1299.
Dean Thomas.
Yeah. So he's not out today, unfortunately. So he's had a couple of dollar bikes off you. Yeah, if I see him, I will get one. I've got my Harley, which I want, so I'll leave it for a bit, see what comes out, see what's new one comes out as. But I think he's put a deposit down, hasn't he, for that new?
Yeah.
Yeah, he told me.
Well, that's it. I mean, the V4 got leaked in MCN, and it wasn't an intention to leak for once. I was good at doing that.
So that's done in there, he's got his bike sorted. Now off to Route 66 for a coffee. like those Ducatis, they are nice. I always told her to Steve, you need stabilizers, you can't ride in a straight line, look. Still, I would pick this, the Harley, over Ducati any day. I really would. You can't beat this. This is relaxing and fun. Sounds awesome. It's just stopped raining anyway, no rain. Just need the sun to come out now. Oh, hang on. Typical. I just said no rain, and what's it doing? It's just started spitting. hope he hasn't forgot we're going down this way. No, he's took it, I can see him. Go round, back down again. I think we can go down there and rejoin it back the other side.
Yeah,
think so.
Yeah, get down, there we
basically have changed your bike or done something.
Well, I'm sure you'll come when you get home.